In this video, I'm going to take apart the Galaxy S7 Edge and talk about repairability. Plus, we're going to cut open the heat pipe, which they're calling liquid cooling. And at the end, I have some interesting stuff to show you with the camera, so buckle up. The easiest part of this whole project is going to be removing the SIM card / SD card tray from the phone, so set that off to the side, make sure you keep all your stuff organized. Then we are going to use a heat gun to heat up the back glass panel of the phone. Basically what we're trying to accomplish here is to soften the adhesive underneath the glass panel so that the glass panel will come off in one piece without cracking. I'm heating up the phone to just hotter than I can touch, where I don't want to leave my finger on there for more than a second. Then I'm going to take a large suction cup, I'm using a car windshield mount, suctioning it to the back of the glass and lifting up ever so slightly, just relieving some of the pressure on the glass between the frame and the glass itself, so I can slide a thin metal pry tool in between the two layers. Once I have that pry tool in, that is the hardest part. Then I can take my heat gun and heat up the glue again. I can slice away the glue a little bit with my pry tool, but I can't get along the edge of the phone or else I'm going to crack the glass. This is where the business cards or playing cards come in, because they can curve around the edge of the Galaxy S7 Edge without cracking the glass. I'm going to speed this part up a little bit. You can see I'm just cutting through the adhesive with my playing cards all the way around the outside, and that's all there is to it. Don't go too deep or you will cut into the QI charger, and I imagine most of you want to keep that. Remove the back glass panel. You can see here the camera lens. You can just push those through. That's how those are replaced. Then there are 12 screws holding down the back frame. I will link all the parts and tools down in the video description, right below that like button. There's this nifty little piece of gold tape. I have no idea what it does, but it's probably important, so set that off to the side where you can remember where it is. Then there's a bunch of little plastic pieces around the edge of the phone. They lock together like little puzzles. So I'm going to snap off this top piece and set that off to the side next to the screws. Then the QI charger panel and plastic will lift off from the back of the phone as well. It just unsnaps from the bottom plastic piece. You can see here the contact points of how the QI charger charges the battery through the motherboard. I'm going to unplug the battery now so that there's not any electricity coursing through the board. Here's the power button cable, the screen ribbon cable, and then here's the volume rocker cable as well. The bottom loudspeaker pops off, and then here's the two contact points that rest on the motherboard so it gets its signal. Here's the fingerprint scanner, and then here's some signal wires. I'm just going to pop those off with my plastic pry tool. You can also lift them off with a pair of tweezers. Here's the earpiece ribbon, just like a little Lego, just unsnap it. Then here's the 5-megapixel front camera. It's a cute little guy. Set that off to the side. Here's for the front sensors. I'm going to pull that off, and then there's one more ribbon cable down at the bottom of the phone for the charging port. I'm going to unsnap that from the back of the motherboard, and then here is the motherboard itself. Once I flip it over, you can already see some discoloration where the processor has melted into the back plastic. The 820 is a pretty hot running processor. Here is the 12-megapixel rear-facing camera. I have some cool stuff I'm going to show you with this towards the end of this video. I'm going to put it back into place, just snapping it in like a little Lego. For the battery removal process, it is fairly difficult. I'm going to use my heat gun again to soften the adhesive between the battery and the frame of the phone, and then using a metal pry tool very, very gently and very carefully, prying it out of the metal frame. You want to make sure not to slide or slice your metal pry tool at all, because if you puncture the battery, it could smoke or explode, you know, and we try to avoid doing those things. Now down by the charging port, there are 3 screws. You can also remove the headphone jack. Now here is the disappointing part of this phone. The charging port has these 2 side ribbons that go around to the back and the menu buttons for the Galaxy S7 Edge, and these are tacked underneath the screen. So in order to remove the charging port, you will have to remove the screen. And the bad thing about that is that the Galaxy S7 Edge has the edge on the AMOLED, and that is near impossible to remove from the frame without damaging it permanently. So a charging port repair is pretty impossible with this phone unless you're doing a screen repair at the same time. To remove the screen from the frame, you're going to use the same process that you use for the back of the phone with playing cards and heat. It will destroy the old screen though, so make sure that you do have a working replacement. A glass-only screen repair for this phone would honestly be the best option with this phone, but those liquid nitrogen machines cost thousands of dollars. My dry ice trick only works with iPhones and not Samsung devices. Hopefully the screen on the regular Galaxy S7 is easier to replace. We'll find out when I do my teardown this week. So let's do something fun. We're gonna jump in and take apart that heat pipe that sits on top of the Snapdragon 820 processor. I'm gonna take my razor blade and slice into it and lift up the copper so we can see the insides. So a heat pipe basically has some vapor inside. This particular heat pipe, there isn't any visible liquid like there was with the Sony Xperia Z5 Premium. We could see a little bit of liquid inside of that one. This one is more similar to the Lumia 950XL, where there's no liquid inside. So here's a poll question for you. There's gonna be a little icon that pops up in the corner of this video. Should a heat pipe inside a cell phone be called liquid cooling when there isn't any visible liquid? Go ahead and respond to that quiz and we'll see what the consensus is. Inside the heat pipe, there are these little copper strands that essentially wick the vapor inside of the tube from one end to the other as it heats up. So it does work as a glorified heatsink. I'm gonna put it all back together and it is good as new. Hit that subscribe button if you've enjoyed this video so far. I'm gonna put the tape back on top with the little foam heat transfer bits, and then we can start putting the foam back together again. I'm gonna put the headphone jack back in by the charging port, and then snap the charging port ribbon cable back into the bottom of the motherboard. Set that back into place, making sure to get all the wires and stuff out from underneath it. That includes the two up by the earpiece, the volume rockers, and the power button connector as well. I'm gonna snap all those back into place, making sure that I can feel them click in underneath my finger, just like a little Lego snapping in. Same thing with the fingerprint scanner and all three signal wires. Battery goes into place, and before I connect that, I wanna make sure everything's plugged in. So I'm gonna get the charging port screwed back into place with the loudspeaker set down on top of that. 5 megapixel front camera goes in, and then I can plug the battery in. Once the battery's plugged in, I can turn on the phone, and I'm gonna do that to test the screen and to show you guys the camera. Now this is pretty cool. It's called optical image stabilization. The camera itself is stabilizing while I move it around, and this is what's gonna keep your videos and images clear while you're walking or holding your phone. There's two ways to stabilize images. There's optical image stabilization and there's digital image stabilization. The digital is just a software where it takes the megapixels and kind of cuts off the corners of it and can stabilize it that way. I prefer the optical image stabilization, where it's actually a mechanical part of it with the little gyros and magnets and little rubber balls inside of the camera unit. Pretty nifty stuff. Once all the screws are back into place, you can take your double-sided tape and put it around the edges. That way your new back will sit in place and stay on. I will link all the replacement parts and stuff down in the video description below, just like all my other videos. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and subscribe. It does help me out a lot. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.